Okay, so it says we're live. Let's make sure we've got voice and video.
Can you see us and hear us?
Me?
But anyone that's in Twitch. Alejandra says they've got us.
Yay!
Yay! So that's what happened. I had to get a sinus infection for the gremlins to go away.
Oh, I was really sick yesterday. Like 103 temp, and I was thinking, oh my gosh, I can't be sick right now. And then it went away this morning.
Well, that's good.
Lucky.
Yeah. 24-hour bug.
Seems like that's been going around a little bit. We're only a couple minutes early, so I'm going to go ahead and start. Hey everyone, this is Fiendish with the DTC Roadshow. Welcome to today's episode. This is number 51, and we're here today with Jadea at Fablight.
Hello.
Alright, so hi, Diva.
Hi!
Okay. I'm really low. Well, okay. I guess I'm going to have to be low because I'm pretty much eating my microphone. In news this week, look for a PTS update on Monday. Blazing Octopus and Tacitus have said that on the Monday's update we should be seeing the bottles on PTS. The new ones, and possibly the next batch of new building blocks, which will include matte black this time.
Yay!
Yeah.
Oh my gosh!
So if you have access to the PTS, please get on there and help make sure that you know, these blocks are scaled right, that they, you know, and let's get that sneak preview in too. They could go live as soon as a couple of weeks. There still hasn't been any word on when we're going to see the Anywhere upgrade, when it goes up to 2520. And that is about it for news. Diva, poke, poke.
Why are you poking me?
Contest.
Oh, you want me to talk about contests? Well, just really quick, speaking of contests, I think you all know about Ashlynn's contest out there on the forums. And next week, or not next week, are you doing your tips and tricks live next week?
Yes. I'm going to do the one that we were supposed to do last week, which was furniture morphing.
Oh, great. So then 2 weeks from today, we're not going to have a road show, but the 2 weeks after that will be when Ashlyn A comes on and we tour the cake contest entries with her. I don't know about any other contests. Do you, Fiendish?
Well, Kit has another giveaway on for Dimension Addicts for uploading sets. This one is autumn themed.
Oh, that's awesome.
And it expires on the 23rd of September.
Wonderful.
So that's coming up.
Thank you.
Yep. And we're starting our tour out today in what Jadea says is her favorite dimension. It's not her first. This is Galaxy Class Starship, if I remember correctly, because I don't have my UI up.
That's right.
Yep. And the details start as soon as you zone in. There's multiple ways up. I'm not going to take the... Well, I guess I'm... Not going to take the elevator just yet because we're in the teleporter bay. And Star Trek is one of those themes that we see a little bit of. Star Trek and Star Wars both are common themes, and I really like this one for the material choices that you used.
Thank you.
You have some unnecessary knickknacks on your UE.
I do. Like what?
Oh, it was my UE. It's a Diva Doofus day, what can I say?
And you use a lot of the trove trees in here. And I'm not a fan of trove trees by any stretch of the imagination, but they actually look really good in here.
Yeah, I don't like them anywhere else. But I needed some sort of plasticky looking material for the cabinets and things.
No.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can
yes.
hear you.
Okay, sorry.
I think they work perfect in here.
Yeah, I couldn't actually open up this one door over here because if you go back there, it's just jammed full of green tree. This thing looks like a monster from the outside.
Oh, yeah. And we're not going to take the PvP pad up. I am going to take the elevator when it comes back down to get me. Because there are multiple ways to get up to the top. And I highly encourage, you know, people to check them all out. Prickly wants to know what makes these blue circles in here. Those are the summer swimming pools. Prickly, has a thing where she wants to, you know, when she says she's going to punch you in the throat, that's a compliment.
Uh-huh.
So, you've been warned.
Okay. I'll be watching for that.
And she's on Fablight.
We give steel neck protectors to all of our guests. So no worries.
Oh, good.
So here we are. I really... like that you started out with the new carpet tiles in here. I know this isn't how it used to be. There have been some new updates.
Yeah, just the carpet, and then I replaced the console with mahogany instead of carved wood because it really is supposed to be more mahogany looking. But carved wood was the best we could do back then.
This whole... I think the bridge is quite possibly my favorite room. And you really like Dromheim walls.
I do.
Not that that's also, anything
nothing
bad.
Wrong with that.
Yeah.
Also, I replaced the overhead light in here. It used to be a lot different than it is now. When I realized I could make a circle using those arches.
Yeah, that's nifty.
So that's a billion and a half necropolis arches and a and a couple of white trove cubes with some, you know, lights underneath it to make it glow.
Looking at the control panel right now. I love this. I'm not a fan of cosmic trees either, but I really like this one in here.
Yeah, they work just perfectly in here, and your control panels are awesome. This is one of the things that makes me call you a detail freak.
Thank you.
And so, which version of Star Trek is your favorite? Is it the old school Captain Kirk or?
No, I like Next Generation best.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I like the new reboot the best. You know, with Chris Pine and
The movies.
Yeah, but I really like. I'm just a Trek fiend, I guess.
No, I actually like the new ones too.
You know what inspired me to do this dimension was actually the sky. I actually originally started it out on the Infinity.
The Edge of Infinity.
Edge of Infinity, because it has the sky, and I thought it would be really cool, you know, to see a planet in your viewfinder, and there's planets out there. And then it didn't really work out there, so I moved it here. And I used to have you going down to, like, an area that was rocked off with a pond and some ruins. That's what the teleporter took you to,
yeah.
And then you go into a cave and teleport back out. But I needed more item space to make 10 forwards, so I had to change it, unfortunately.
Well, The upgrade is supposed to kick in at some point. They're still saying before the expansion. So this one will go up to 2520. And since you've already done a tier 5 upgrade, it'll automatically go. So you'll even save some upgrade costs that way. I went into the sick bay.
Skip the conference room?
Well, I just kind of ran through it.
Love these chairs in the conference room.
The chairs are always so much fun, aren't they? I really like some coming up with some of these, you know, medical instruments, because they're so small. It was really hard.
Oh, yeah.
Like this, I can't remember what it's called now, tricorder over here.
But using the books was a really good idea for this.
Just great details.
Those are also yellow trove cubes on the displays, just the corner edge sticking out. And what I really liked about it is it looks like they move.
It does.
Like there's a display going on in digital readout. My husband's listening to the live stream in the other room.
Hi, hubby. There. We'll say hi.
He's pretty shy.
Now, one new thing I did notice in, I can't remember what the name
10
was.
Forward?
Yeah, that thing. This new wall art that you did, well, it's basically an adjustment of what was here. I love this paint on this wood.
All I did was replace the wood to mahogany from the carved wood, because the carved wood was kind of hiding the detail of the paint. And not really giving, I mean, the actual real piece back there in the show is much more red and like lava-y. But that was the best I could do.
Yeah. And there's a ton of music boxes making all these ceilings.
Yes. Music boxes. Trove music boxes and a couple of siren ones. Mermaid ones? Some are there.
The siren song?
Yeah, that's it. So I don't know what it sounds like in here. I tend to keep my music off.
Yeah, I don't know either. I don't usually play with sound on, and I never stream with the sound on.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Then I do want to call attention to the door handles with the Starfleet insignias.
Yeah.
That was kind of fun figuring out.
And use some snow paint in here too on these carved wood tables. That looks really good. The way that the pattern of the carved wood picks up the snow.
Yeah, it's kind of different. I thought, at first, I just wanted the snow paint to make the striping, or to make the table tops white, or just the tables white, and then I decided I liked that, so I left it like that.
Yeah, those bases look so cool.
Kind of futuristic.
Mm-hmm. That was a sick bay.
This is the conference room.
So how long did it take you to make this one?
Well, I'm kind of obsessive. So when I get really inspired to do a project, I tend to work on it 16 hours a day till it's done, because I'm disabled, so I have a lot of free time. And I really can't say, about a week probably, but the amount of hours would be a lot more than that sounds like.
Oh, sure.
You like my Borg cube?
Do you like the Borg cube?
Yes, love that.
And there's been a lot of the chat comments are about the Borg cube.
Mm-hmm. Maybe I should be watching.
You'll be assimilated.
That's why I like this one. You come in here and you can't help it. You know, you just start saying things from Star Trek.
Do you like this little ship model? I've moved on to the I think it's the captain's quarters now.
Yeah, this is the captain's ready room. Yeah, I do. I thought it turned out pretty well.
Yeah, it's great. I love the wall art in here, too. Mm-hmm.
Now, this is something I just did a couple weeks ago. This wall art wasn't here before.
Love that.
Finally found some use for my tree stars.
Oh.
So that's where all the glowy lights are.
Uh-huh.
And when you build, do you use tools or do you just freehand it?
I always do both. You know, if I have something that's going to be repeated a lot, like these walls, I'll just copy and paste them. A lot of times I'll put something down and sight it in as best I can, and then I'll bring up tools and, you know, straighten up the angle completely. And I'm usually not far off, but you know, I like to be perfect.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'll use save sets, you know, if I want to, like, have two tables, like in here. I have two tables, so I want them both to be the same.
Right.
Sure.
Make one and do a save set of the other. It really depends on what I'm doing. If it's walls or stuff like that, usually you will use tools. But if it's, you know, creating something, then I don't. Creating something that I'm just trying to figure out. You guys are probably like me, where you put stuff down and you look at it and you hate it and you pick something else up and you try something different. Spend hours and hours doing that.
Yeah. The geode is getting a lot of commentary. And we'll see that again.
Yeah, well, he actually had the geode on his desk, So that's why I decided to try and make one.
And Earl Grey hot, yep.
Yep.
we were actually talking about that before we started.
Yep. I just thought this would be kind of a fun place to come role play with some friends at. Haven't done that yet, but it would still be fun.
And I think this is the one we can't go through.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the one. You don't want to see what's back there.
But that's good. I like the illusion of it.
Yeah. Well, it's actually there on the actual bridge. So I had to put it in. I wanted to put a do not, I'm out of order sign on it, but you can't really do that.
Do it in Klingon. There was a guy I worked with, and this might say something about how many nerds I work with. He had a sign on his door that, you know, part of the sign was done in English, and then there was another notification in Klingon. So, yeah.
That's awesome.
Prickly says this is definitely the nerdiest DTC yet, and it pleases me.
So, well, maybe I won't get punched in the throat then.
Oh no.
Oh, no, it just means extra, probably.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Did we show all of this one?
I think you did the teleporter room already, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
I just didn't take the PvP banner.
Yeah, actually, I think we are done in here.
All right.
But it's be great for people to come and explore it in person because it's fun to find the different ways from where you zone in up to the ship.
Yep. And for the next one, we're going to one of my favorites, and that's Jadea's home, which was just reopened this morning. Well, Kula says he's going to phaser people on your behalf.
Oh, thank you, Kula.
Yep, I'm taking a page from D.Va's book and I'm walking.
Oh, Sea Mage is going to want to kill you.
I haven't seen her in the chat.
Oh, okay, you're safe then. This is another beauty filled with wonderful details, and I love the wall art that you include in your dimensions. Mm-hmm. One of my favorite arts.
I love these windows in here. Now, what was the inspiration for this one?
I don't know. I just started building. I was going to build it for the contest, and actually before I hit more than 2,000 items, I started working on Water's Edge at the same time, so I was building both of them. And I had this one mostly built when I started Water's Edge, and I debated for days on which one to enter. Days. And then I got too many items in here, so it sort of...
made the choice for you.
Yeah. So I guess it was your contest that got me started building it.
And that's the only contest that we've ever ran more than one of. And I don't know, I think we've got the details worked out for our next one.
There are some things in here I still want to redo, but I now have time, so. Yeah. Like, I'm not enamored of the cabinet doors.
The handles.
Yeah, I like the handles. I don't like the marble. And I don't like the ice. I don't know.
I like just the insane amount of items to make the stripes on the walls, though. Oh.
Okay, for that one, I definitely use tools.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sure. Because that would be really repetitive to just...
I think I took like 300 green planks.
Oh, yeah.
Luckily, they're really cheap on the auction house. Since they drop.
In this bathroom.
So pretty. Yeah. I love that tub, and here's some of your beautiful wall art.
This is probably my favorite room I've ever made.
I mean, I hate making bathrooms, but this one is really nice.
Bathrooms aren't that bad.
And this, I love this tile floor with the Dromheim walls again.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that was fun. This bathroom got remade about 7 times. It started out black, then it became green marble, and then ice came out, and then
yeah,
I mean, just a lot of changes.
Yeah, and we've seen a lot of love this year for Dimensions, and I hope we see some more.
It's the reason I came back. I quit for quite a while because it's just kind of frustrating, you know, when you've kind of reach the end of your ability to create anything new because the items are so limited. Especially if you're like me, who apparently the only thing I like to build is houses.
There's a few that are ships. Your toilet paper is getting a lot of comments.
I love that.
Yeah.
What a fun detail.
The curtains. I love these curtains in here. The morphed ones with the firecrackers and the dragon scales.
Yep.
Yeah, I really liked those. They turned out pretty well. And this is my ballroom where we can hold parties.
Hey, gotta have cool. An entertainment area.
It even has a record player.
Mm-hmm.
I love that.
Heading that direction because I was looking. I was wanting to make like a console record player, and I was like, I know who has one, and I went looking for this one, and I was like, it's gone.
Well, it's back now. Again, books are a wonderful thing.
Yes.
And I just replaced the carved wood with mahogany this morning, so it's better than it did. My mini bar over here.
Yeah, that's cool.
I'm in the kids' room now. I really like this room.
It's cute. I wish I'd had a room like this when I was a kid.
It is. Yeah. It's darling.
Very colorful.
Well, you know, I have all these Trove cubes. I'll figure out something to do with them.
Yeah, this is great uses for them.
The little lettering on the walls and the numbers.
Oh, I forgot to point out how good your lettering is on your Home Sweet Home wall art. It's so pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Down in the bathroom.
Obviously, those are open scrolls.
Mm-hmm. I mean, this is like just the kind of place I love to tour. It's not a huge house, but man, it is just jam-packed with loads of detail.
A water fountain.
Mm-hmm.
Water wall.
You really don't miss any chance to add special details. I know, like, in the kitchen you have that one little shelf up on the at the end of the upper cabinets.
Yeah.
You know, just lots of pretty details.
Well, it looks empty. You have to do something.
This desk area is just awesome. I love the detail of the open drawers and the rolly chair.
My storage boxes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, open cupboard in the long part of the desk and a safe. I mean, really, really cool.
And a printer. I think this is probably one of the few morphed printers I've ever seen.
And a laptop, and I don't know if that really looks like a mouse, but...
Yes, it does. And okay. I love the window you put on the screen, the Windows window. Yeah.
The pop-up
window. So fun. Yeah. So fun.
Yeah. I also stole this laptop for Water's Edge. They got made here first, though.
I love how you use the blue books to emulate the keys on there.
Yeah, doesn't that turn
out? That works perfect.
I was really, really happy with it.
It looks so good.
Did she go upstairs? Oh, there we are. The bedroom.
Yep.
I'd like to live
here. I'm upstairs in the master room.
I stole the cat out of here. There used to be a cat on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
But he's now in the secret garden. He likes it better outside anyway.
I'm still holding out hope for dogs.
Well, that'd be nice. I really want horses. I love horses. I'd love to build a stable and have a bunch of horses. That'd be
I want a
awesome.
skunk.
A skunk.
This little cabinet over here just loaded with details. Like this chest with the Indian treasure hoards. And these doors, these French doors are just awesome.
Thank you. Your little short, tiny balcony.
Hey, that's.
Got a pretty view, though.
Some amazing details in here. Loads of detail. And
My favorite.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
So my favorite is this candle.
Yeah.
Which is a wine
Really
bottle
pretty.
upside down with a limestone pole sticking through it.
Cool.
More open drawers.
Apparently, I have trouble closing them.
I love details like that.
Yeah.
Oddities, broken things, all that kind of stuff.
And don't forget the backyard.
Yep, I'm coming around that way.
Well, she ran out the other way.
Yeah, I ran out the front door.
Yeah, I'm going to the backyard through the back door.
It's a long way to walk.
I'm not walking.
Oh, she cheated and ran. Cheater, cheater.
So this is a pool you can actually swim in.
Yeah.
Oops.
This is such a beautiful base dimension.
Yeah.
It really is. I wish I could have like five of them. I wish they would allow us to have more than one instance of the same dimension.
Yeah. That's a pretty common request. Probably not. I don't know. Didn't we ask Tacitus about that when he was on Diva? I think he.
Yeah, they have no plans to do that, he
Yeah.
said.
I mean, you can do it with alts, but then it doesn't have your name on it, so people go don't find it.
Put a tag on your dimension name.
Yeah, I've tried that. It doesn't seem to help.
This is just a gorgeous dimension. So, I know I've seen some people in chat saying that they're going to take the time to come check these out in person, and I really, really do encourage you to do so.
Me too.
Yay.
'Cause there are as many details as we're showing, there's still a lot
Oh,
more that we're not focusing on, like
yeah,
the track lighting and
missing so much.
do you care if we show Moonshade Cove just so we
No.
can see how long you've been doing this?
Nope.
Awesome. That's where I want to go next is Moonshade Cove.
Okay.
And if you've been building for a long time, then chances are good that you've seen this one before. Or if
I
you've.
Ebon Rose.
Yeah, by Ebon Rose. Which I just found out today. Was your alt.
Yes.
And I am gonna run down. Oh, but I'm not running, I'm walking. So, yeah, we're gonna run down here.
I used to have a dimension entry point here, but I had to steal it. So sorry, you have to run down now.
Oh, it's fine. Teridan says, I remember that one. Yeah. That's a good idea.
This is the first one that I remember seeing where somebody used this part of Moonshade.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I really wanted a shower. So that's why I built it here.
All right.
Now, I have updated this a little bit since back then.
Yeah.
With the new walls. It used to have actually wood walls. The just plain wood walls. Then when the new walls came out and the limestone, I replaced them.
I think, did you change your appliances in the kitchen?
I don't think so.
They weren't ever the graveyard towers?
Not the appliances.
Oh, okay.
The cabinets.
I just remember being in awe of the graveyard towers. I think I didn't know about that item when I toured here.
Yeah, way back when.
Yeah, was way back when. Because I've known about them for at least 2 weeks now. Maybe longer.
I have kind of stolen a few things out of here, so it might not be as... This still needs a lot of updating.
You know, though, as old as this is, and I mean, this is less than 1,000 items in here.
Yeah, T4! I can't believe that still.
Well, I mean, you know, this is what we used to have to work with.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
This is so awesome.
It's the first grandfather clock I ever saw, actually, in a den was this one, which I figured out one day. And then I see a lot of others build differently. But since then, using like the sword, hanging sword, whereas mine are poles, it doesn't move. And it has a rice for the face, a rice barrel.
Yep.
Because we didn't have white back then.
Nope.
It's pretty.
Just like these algaes making the plates.
Yep.
I mean, that's an old, old thing that you just don't see anymore anywhere. And the cheeseburger's kind of newish.
Yes, just, it's an idol. Mm-hmm. Three-tiered idol, I think. Upside down for the burger, patty, and then bread. I think I added that later.
And then the appliances are the flower stands.
Yes.
Now, are those the ones from the newsletter or just the ones from when the wedding items came out?
Wedding items.
Yeah. Pretty much the same thing, but...
Not something you can use unless you have a really thick wall mm-hmm. or to put them in because those flowers go out a long way.
Yeah.
For the angled pieces or the back up and down pieces. Not up and down, sideways.
I mean, this is, you know, this is still a good dimension. And I'm
oh, yeah.
Glad now that I know that it's yours. So...
Aw, oh, thank you. Yeah, I stole a few things. I think there was a plant here.
Hey, I'm pretty sure a lot of other people have stolen a lot of things out of this dimension.
So, in here we have a sauna. This first door. Oh, I stole the sauna part. And it used to have a fire right here. With smoke coming, a steam coming out. Mm-hmm. I'll have to put that back in. But it's still kind of steamy in here because of the waterfall.
Yep.
And then, of course, the ever-present bathroom.
Yep. Back in the day when toilet paper was a bedroll.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
Because I know, like, when I was first starting out, I would come and look at this one and just be like, how did you do this? How do you do this? And yeah.
And figured it out. Oh, see, we didn't have the lights back then, the orbs, nope. I guess. Or it was really hard to get your hands on them anyway. So, yeah, red source stone.
Yeah, the puzzle was the only way to get those.
Yeah.
Or pay through the nose on the auction house.
And the old way we used to do water. Stasis tubes.
Stasis tubes.
And I put some blue source stone chunks underneath it to give it the glow.
Yep.
Still wish they would give us mirrors.
Me too.
So here's my shower. Yay. That's the whole reason I built this in. And then, of course, you have your little bathtub. Really big bathtub. Now, this used to be a ramp, but I replaced it with the stairs when they came out.
Yep. Because we didn't used to have stairs.
Nope.
Way back in the olden days.
Oh, and this dimension was built entirely without tools. Because I didn't know about them back then.
Now, I really like that the cabinetry from the kitchen, the gravestone tower, carried over to the bedroom.
I think there's a piece missing here. Not really sure what happened to it. So don't turn that direction. I'll have to fix that. Okay. Don't even come in here. I completely took everything out of this room a few weeks ago. I used to have a little garden area with some sitting chairs, and there was a wall over here. Sorry about that.
It's all good.
I'll have to fix it back up. All in the little kids' room. Desk made all of books.
Mm-hmm.
Cute.
This was the hardest thing right here. These windows.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Especially if you weren't using any kind of tool. There's a lot of repetition there.
Yeah. It took a long time, and it was really annoying.
You since added a bridge.
Yeah, it used to just be a plank across there, but I got this bridge one day, and I just thought that would go really well in here.
This is still a great looking dimension. I'm gonna hop the rail.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's definitely one of my beloved nostalgia dimensions.
But we're gonna head off now to Water's Edge.
Oh, good.
Which I know was the entry for your Cozy Cottages contest.
Yes.
This is a really pretty house.
I still like it.
Yeah. Hey, that's the important part.
Yeah.
So cool. Love this structure and all your railings around it.
Those were a pain. Because the old dimension tools had a problem with, the angled.
Yep.
planks.
Rotational bugs, yep. So, have you switched over to Tinker Tools?
I use both now because there's one thing I don't like about Tinker Tools, and that is there's no way to clear out the data you had in there without actually going to it and deleting it. So I wish they'd put a clear button. Otherwise, I would use it exclusively because I really like a lot of features that it has. But like when I'm, you know, I'm doing some stairs, and then I need to, you know, copy and paste something else somewhere else, I have to go in and take out the measurements for the, you know, the XYZs before I can use it.
Oh, from the text fields.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, Alejandro points out that the guy that makes Tinker Tools is actually in the chat today. So.
Oh, no. I love your program.
That's good feedback for him, though. I mean, you know.
I mean, I love that it's there, and I don't want it to not be there when I open the window, but if there was just a little button I could push that would clear it if I don't need it anymore, that would be fantastic. I mean, because there are times when it's very handy to have it stay.
And just.
Now, I love how you decorated the interior here. It's so pretty.
Mm-hmm. I love the Scrywood pattern.
You actually reused Jean-Luc Picard's geode there.
Yeah. I did. And the candle from the other dim. But this
So you did, yes.
But this one was closed. I mean, that one was closed, so I was never seen.
And I think this one was Sailor's Judge's Choice, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I did get a Judge's Choice Award.
I love the liquor bottle here.
Lots and lots of pictures on the walls.
Mm-hmm.
And here's our roller chair.
So good.
Thank you. I liked my little black dress.
I love your yeah. I love your closet and your hangers and the clothes.
The shoes.
The shoes.
Yeah, the shoes are awesome.
My little jars up here.
It's just detail freak extraordinaire.
Well, there's got to be something in there. Otherwise, it's just an empty room.
Yep.
I guess I could have put a door and closed it. Well, that wouldn't have been nearly as much fun.
I love your Dutch oven pot.
Thank you.
And I like this, I like this sideboard over here.
Mm-hmm. Very pretty.
The hutch, China hutch.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, and you got that yellow jar. Oh. Hopefully that'll be one of the ones that shows up with the PTS update.
Oh, it's not just a rare item you occasionally get if you're really lucky.
Yeah.
Well, I hope they fix it a little bit. I mean, it's kind of triangular on one side. isn't quite round. Yeah, kind of weird. So I have to turn it just the right way. Looks a little odd from some angles.
Here's another great bathroom.
My comb.
Yeah, that's such a fun detail.
Yeah. And all the little jars and bottles.
That comes like 13 planks.
Yeah.
Hairspray.
Mm-hmm. All those little clutter items make it like somebody really lives here.
Yeah.
Love them.
Well, I do, right?
Sure.
It is nice to see that, you know, you build and then over time you're still going back in and making changes and tweaking stuff. I mean,
yeah. Well, when we get new stuff, I think, oh, that would look really good in here.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to see a bunch of rumors about Fiendish and I showering together.
Oh, boy.
And I'm going to start them.
Love all the details.
I want the pie.
Mm-hmm.
I want to eat it.
I was glad they have finally put it in the game where you don't have to morph it.
Yeah.
This is an awesome deck.
It's a nice view.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, I drink a lot of sweet berry cocktails.
And I'm going to run again. The shades. Again, you know, please check these out in person.
Especially my sliding doors.
Yep, we already spent some. I spent some time looking at those.
It has all the rails mm-hmm. and everything.
Yeah, I know I'm crazy.
And we got just a little bit of time left, so we're going to head to Port Royal.
Well, do we have to?
If you don't want to, we can go to the Secret Garden instead.
Yeah, that would be better. Port Royal's, okay. Like, really, I mean, it's got some cool stuff, but...
Okay, let me... Port Royal is actually pretty good, so just ignore what she says that it's not.
Yeah, it's what I was earlier today, having fun re-exploring mm-hmm. it.
And it's a lot of area to explore and look around. Now, this was... The entry from the contest that just ended.
Yes.
We didn't.
Now, I didn't really want to put the entry here in the water, but everywhere else is actually on an item because all this is, as you know, is just a sand hill back here.
Yep.
And so people kept falling through, and I didn't want that. So I moved it back here.
One of my favorite parts of this is this red brick stairway, and then your walls, kind of the walls and posts, the red brick walls and posts through, just are so beautiful.
Thank you. I really love the brick.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Now, do you like the red brick the best out of all of them, or do you like the others any?
I think, you know, the red brick is the best if you're doing something modern. The others look older, like, you know, the the gray is actually more like a maybe a castle wall or something type. So it just really
like
depends
black,
on what you're.
Yeah, I like the black myself.
I haven't.
I like all of them.
Yeah.
I'm just happy to have more. So I put flowers on these stumps to bring out their. Just make them colorful. My little chairs.
They look so pretty.
And again, with the tons of details.
Now there's 6 colored stained glass window projectors for each panel.
Wow.
And then there's 2 for each small rug and 3 for the longer rugs. And there's 4 for this round one. So that's a lot of stained glass projectors.
Yeah.
The rugs look kind of paisley.
Yeah.
Very, very pretty. Love that. So creative. But, I mean, you started with this stairway, this platform and the stairway with the red brick. And then... you curve it up, that's so pretty, but then you have all these walls and the kind of courtyard that's between the gazebo and the wall and the fire pit, and it's just such a pretty theme through the structure.
I wanted it to give kind of the impression of like kind of a wild area that has, you know, been reclaimed a little bit, and like, so this is supposed to be a nicely manicured lawn here by the swing. And I think that's what it looks like.
Yeah,
you know, with
it does.
Flower beds along the edges.
Mm-hmm.
You know, over in England, gardens mean yard. So I don't know. Wasn't sure if they counted the whole thing as part of the garden in the contest or not.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
And I see that you have almost 400 items left, and you said earlier that you kind of have some thoughts for an additional area or some other features that you want to add, and so I'll be waiting for those, because I noticed that you had PvP flags in here, and I spent a long time looking for them because I thought, goody goody, I can see more.
it's on the other side of the gate, sorry.
But you said that's for future, so
yeah.
I'll be revisiting this for sure to see whatever you add.
Mm-hmm.
It's so gorgeous.
Thank you.
I'm heading toward the playground now.
And I really loved the roofing, the grayscale roofing for the wall.
Yeah.
I thought
yeah.
it was really pretty.
Mm-hmm.
I like this little climbing wall.
Yeah, I did too.
Yeah, that's so cute.
Climbing wall, jungle gym, the net.
That's super fun.
Figured the kids needed something to do while I was, you know, cooking hot dogs.
Shoot, make the kids cook the hot dogs and you can play on the seesaw.
Yeah.
Oh, and this is such a pretty illustration of, another one of the new woods here.
Yeah, they really sparked my inspiration, you know, the mahogany, the wood, the dark wood. I really don't like the oak.
Yeah, I like it for small things, like some accent pieces. I don't.
Yeah, the pattern on it is just, it's too busy. And the rectangles, the pattern used to grow with the rectangle. And so you could actually use the rectangles for large pieces, but then they fixed that. So now they don't look good anymore.
Yeah.
Which is too bad, because I would really love to do some oak kitchens. But not with that pattern. So, mahogany and dark wood.
I'm not going to lie, the dark wood is pretty far and away my favorite.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. It is really nice.
I like all of them. I mean, I have been... My real life has kept me with very little playtime lately, and so I haven't been able to do as much touring as I usually do, but the touring that I have managed to fit in, I mean, it's so fun to go and see all the different ways people are using all this new stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just like every other item. People get a new item and they think of, you know, 100 times what you'd expect, ways to use it. So it's so fun.
Yeah, but every time I go look at other people's stuff and they see what they do, that I'm thinking, oh man, that's so clever, but now I can't use it because it wouldn't be my idea anymore, and then I'd be stealing it, and then I'd feel bad. So, it's kind of silly. There's this little area over here you can sit in, mm-hmm. read.
Yeah, fun little sitting area over there by the past the waterfall.
Yep. Too slow.
I bet you're so slow I can get in a lot more bonks.
I'm not walking anymore. You know why I'm not walking anymore?
Am I little... bonking you?
No, because it's time for giveaways.
Koi pond here.
That's your job, Diva.
Yeah, I know. I forgot to get the Nightbot squirrels running.
Well, while she's doing that, I really want to say thank you for coming on with us today, Jadea. It was very nice to meet you.
It was really good to meet you, too, and I had a great time. Thank you very much for asking me.
Oh.
It was our pleasure to have you on.
I was honored.
Prickly says, these Dems gave me a stroke, so thanks a lot.
Sorry, Prickly.
Nightbot likes me as much today as every other day.
Oh, yeah, there's a shocker.
Give me just a second.
Okay, Alejandro just really likes the new slow speed on the camera. I used to always walk, and then I don't know, somewhere along the way I got out of the habit. For small areas, I think I'm going to go back to the walking, but for large landscapes, it will still probably be at a run because I don't want to spend 10 years on a path. Unlike Diva.
Don't.
And besides, we know that there's going to be details that we miss with these. I mean, I really do encourage, you know, people to go tour on their own and go look and see what's out there, because there's something on every shard. Every shard. I saw some conversation earlier about Sea Stone and Blood Iron, and you know there's some good dimensions on Sea Stone and Blood Iron too.
It's just so hard to find them. I wish there was an easier way.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you gotta dig, but they are there. I mean, I really would like to see a favorites tab added for,
oh yeah,
for dimensions, or, you know, some way to flag a dimension that I've been to, but that I want to keep going back to.
Yeah, I wish they would eliminate from the list all dimensions with 0 items.
Yeah. Or set the...
default to
closed.
Yeah.
I know they were saying that that's a UI thing, and with the expansion being worked on, that's not something that's in the works for a new thing. Possibly after 4.0, maybe. They said it was something they were willing to look into.
Well, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
Remember the days when we used to get 800 or 900 votes on a dimension?
Yeah.
Now you're lucky to break 150. It's sad. We need more dimmers to come back.
Indeed.
Okay, it's almost loaded.
Almost.
It's almost loaded the list of people in chat. So if you haven't typed anything in like the last 5 minutes, just type something so you'll be eligible for the giveaways.
Cassiar brings up she would love to see dims with nothing in them to see what they look like without stuff. And I got that.
Yeah, I understand that too.
I do that. If the default was set to close, but you wanted to have an empty display, you can click that button and open it. And then, like, tag it as a, you know, display. I know on Galidra, there is somebody that did have most of the Dreamweaving dimensions open to the public empty. And they were marked as display dims. And I think there was another set on Broodwalked.
Or they could actually let us preview a dim before we buy it.
Yeah. Yeah, I know there was talk for a while before Mordicus left where they were talking about like a dimension hub, but they never put out any kind of details as to what would be in that hub. It would be awesome if there was like a preview. Hey!
And an inventory system.
Yep.
Congrats, Red Six!
Congrats.
Congratulations!
And if you win a prize, please stay in Twitch until I send you the code in a Twitch mail.
Okay.
And here goes another one. Kula!
What'd Kula win?
I'm doing corgi pets.
Oh.
Corgi radar corgi pets.
I think he left. Oh. Told me he was leaving for a couple hours.
He's still in our chat.
Yep.
Sparklin. And these are all, Rift codes that you do on your account, so you can give them to somebody if you've already won something.
Yep. They will expire early.
Should I do 5 fiendish?
Sure.
5 of each?
Sure.
Okay.
Stuff like mine too. Winter charm.
Yeah,
grass.
Winter charm. And
Aleandre,
Winter Charm, Sparklin, Kula.
Aleandre says, please reroll. Because I think we're about to hit full saturation.
Has she won like 10 of these? Okay, I'll reroll since you asked, Aleandre. Thank you for being generous. So, Mart. Okay, so now comes for racing snails.
Oh man, I should be in the channel. Just kidding.
Gosh, all of our audience members all have all these things. Okay, this is for a snail.
Prickly!
Congratulations.
And here's another snail.
Phineas Fingers. Congrats.
That's 2.
That's an awesome username, by the way.
Sierra.
And Prickly says she already has a snail.
Well, I'm going to give it to you any way prickly, and then you can decide who to give it to.
She's lazy.
Because I'm lazy.
Lynx 3D, congrats.
Hey, Katumi, hooray for Katumi, my savior of my sanity, the builder of Tinker Tools, hooray.
Yay, we love you.
I do too. Okay, let's see, how many snails was that? One?
Whoa.
Two?
I love Pivot.
Oh, and
Godzilla. Yeah, I think Alan, we've given you one before, but you can gift that to somebody.
No, she's going to sell it.
Okay, whatever. But what I don't know, what can't hurt me. What happens on the road show stays on the road show.
Yep.
Okay, I'm doing one more snail.
And Jade.
And Jador! Hooray!
That's not me.
Yeah, it's Jador from Greybriar.
I just wanted to make sure you didn't think so.
I think that was five. So, I'm going to start handing out the gifts now, so please stay in if you won something.
Yep. And thank you again for coming on with us today, Jadea. It was a lot of fun.
Yes, thank you, Jadea.
Turn your dimensions and so many fabulous details. Again, please visit them in person, you know, vote them up. Show them some of that plus one love, because we will never run out.
Yay.
And remember,
thank you so much.
Remember, there's no road show 2 weeks from today, but 2 weeks after that, we'll be visiting...
No, on the 8th.
Oh, I'm sorry, on October 8th, we'll be visiting Ashlynn's contest entries.
Yep.
With Ashlynn, yay!
Yep, so that one's also going to be late because she's in Australia.
Oh, yes, it's at 3 p.m.
Yep.
Server time.
So until next week, we'll be back covering Furniture Morphing for Tips and Tricks Live, and then on the 1st of October, I'll be taking a day off just because I want...
What?
And, yeah. So thank you, everybody, and happy touring.
Have fun!